Hey guys, the Langbanger here. A new deck profile for March 2013, and we have Chain Beats. This is another post Hidden Arsenal 7 deck. Now, some of you guys may be able to use these cards that aren't legal yet at your locals. That's fine, go ahead and try out this deck then. But most of us that follow the rules, or, you know, want to be legit about it, we can't use Thunderbird yet. So, mid-April, late April, we'll have it out, it'll be legal, and everyone's definitely going to try out this sort of deck. There's a whole lot of ways to use this. I mean, you can kind of go the chain burn route and use accumulated fortunes and a bunch of other trap cards because your Thunderbirds and your Rabbits work as chain links, and it just works really, really well. But let's go into the monsters. You have 3 Banisher, 3 Thunderbird, 2 Fossil Donna, 2 Tour Guide, and 3 Rabbit. The point of my monsters is to just put as much pressure on my opponent as possible. Tour Guide may seem weird at first, but obviously it's one of the best monsters in the game still. I mean, if they were to put the card to 1, that would have changed things. Like, if they would have put Tour Guide to 1 and kept saying it around, that would be like a whole different ball game, I feel like. But regardless, I mean, a 1 card exceed just to put more pressure on your opponent, why not? Banisher of the Radiance, a really powerful card. If you really think of all the decks out there, there's not that many cards that can get over this card on its own. You either have to do something to bring it out, or, you know, play another card to be able to get over it. And that's pretty crucial. I mean, 1600 attack is nothing to laugh at. The 3 Thunderbird, 3 Windup Rabbit, they're there to just dodge my opponent's plays. They want to play Mirror Force, I don't care. Torrential, I don't care. Dark Hole, whatever. Bottomless, you know, the list goes on. You'll be able to dodge the cards and be able to keep the cards and do something next turn. I mean, pretty much, like, the theory is to just keep bringing them back, play another card to get rid of your opponent's monster, and then just beat face. And sooner or later, they're going to have to start to play cards to stay alive, but they're going to be minusing themselves so much to where you're eventually just going to win that battle. Onto the spells, you have Dark Hole, 2 MST, 2 Duality, and 3 Soul Taker. If you guys want, you can minus a Soul Taker for a 3rd MST, but to be honest, you don't really need the 3rd MST. I mean, you're shedding off the graveyard, and you have 6 monsters that just dodge cards, so that's kind of my mindset on that. Onto the traps, you have 2 Bottomless, 2 Escape Device, and I guess I may as well say this real quick. It's a trap card, and it says each player chooses 1 monster they control, then shuffles it into the deck. Think on that for a second while I finish out the traps. You have 1 Evacuation Device, 3 Dimensional Prison, 3 Macrocosmos, 2 Mirror Force, 1 Solemn Judgment, 1 Warning, 2 Starlight Road, and 2 Torrential Tribute. Now, the Escape Device, really solid card to go with my Thunderbirds and Windup Rabbit especially. Because you play the card, you select, each player selects a monster, and hey, how about I choose this monster that can just dodge? That's really cool stuff. Now, when comparing Escape Device to Evacuation Device, sometimes the Escape Device might be better because maybe you may not want to bounce that Megalo to your opponent's hand. Maybe it's a Priestess you don't want to bounce because they could just play the card again. Instead, put it to the deck and we can be a little happier in life, feel a little safer. To Starlight Road, as you can see, I'm using a lot of sets, so I want to make sure that I'm able to set cards and not get totally jacked up. There's a lot of times to where I'll play 1 Starlight Road and my opponent will think they're safe, so then they'll do another play and then they'll walk right into another Starlight Road. I mean, it gives you all the protection in the world. And as I said, I mean, look at all those traps. There's 19 right there. So you definitely don't want to get blown out by a heavy, Black Rose, I mean, Torrential, Mirror Force. I mean, there's so many cards out there that are being used right now. So I just think of that as really good. So let me know what you guys think. As for the monster lineup, I was thinking of using Doomcow or Thunder King. Doomcow didn't seem that right with my monsters that can bounce away, so, and Thunder King just with Macro and Banisher. I just don't think Thunder King would work out that well, but who knows, things may change. We'll see how things work out in testing and how the meta evolves. Alright guys, that's it for now. Thanks for watching and have a good day. Peace.